There was a girl behind a bright orange bar, mixing beer with 7-Up. Her dimple smile was just like a magazine at the constellations inside of a cup. I didn't know the faces on the shining walls of that tiny outdoor grill, as my secret dreams were drowned by engines climbing up that hill. So spectacular, her beauty. She was a blonde, but her roots were black, with a soul like the flowers that are growing in the grass on the side of the railroad tracks. The silence was somewhat broken by the claws of the chimera I was stirring in my glass, smoke rings drifting. Sun so close to the horizon turns the windows to stained glass. Castle razor lights and fingerprints on a machine that pumps the gas. In a mirrored soda fountain, I saw her cherub features glow. And me, I was starting to slowly feel so absolutely low. Awkward and just a little bit shy, put some money in an old jukebox. I feel like Robert Ryan in the House of Bamboo, made by 20th Century Fox. I didn't want to say what a fool would say, but a fool I was starting to be. So I pointed to the picture of a Hindu god on a tin can of Indian tea. Play games instead of saying I would love to talk with you. Your presence calls my heart to action, but I'm unsure of what to do. Can you feel this melancholy? Hear that dark, unholy sound when everything explodes here, darling? Let's not be around. Song was over, but the ghost of his song was still there. Like a trickle of stardust kept on winding its way through the thick of a neon head. Static killed all the clatter of the uptight unsaid words. And me, some surprises made the whole thing seem surprisingly absurd. As it always happens, everything inside of me changed. The pink plastic curtains stopped reflecting the light that made this little place so cool and strange. The road started calling, so I paid the bills. I saw her eyes looked a little less bright. I left a dollar on the counter and I drove off into what would soon be night.
Grazie! Grazie!